want to specifically thank the two prosecutors who worked so hard in my office, Rick Dusterhoff, who is the director of our criminal division, and Andy Johnson, and also Jen Malinger, who worked so closely with Kira's family to provide victim services. In a moment like this, where this case has touched this community so greatly, the bottom line is the conviction was gotten today, but at the end of the day, nothing that happened in the courtroom is going to bring back Kira to her family, and that is incredibly sad. But for what it's worth, today in the courtroom, we hope that we have achieved justice, and we will hold and we've held the defendant accountable in this case. The sentencing will occur at a later time, and I don't want to go into the details of that, so I'm going to just stop right there with my comments. I'm going to turn it over to Kira's family. They're going to have a few brief comments. We'll take a few questions, and then we can move on. Thank you.
As far as the sentencing wise, no matter what sentence he gets is enough. We will never have our daughter back, but at least justice has been done. Thank you.
Any quick questions? We will take a few questions.
Talk about how quickly you were able to prosecute this case and try it. It's a pretty short time frame.
Since when we charged the case?
In the trial, the prosecution and the trial itself, this all happened pretty quickly.
The whole trial itself? Well, typically, this was quite a longer trial than normal.
The start date and everything from when the incident occurred. And...
Well, the complaint was charged out February 28th. Yeah. And so, and the case progressed along. I think it was scheduled sometime in May for first trial, and then we ended up having the trial today, or finishing the trial today.
John, talk about the circumstantial sort of case that this was. I mean, this was a complicated case to prosecute. There were potentially a lot of holes. I thought the defense attorney did a pretty good job of poking those holes.
Did a better job. This was a circumstantial case, and that's a tougher case to prove because there was no direct evidence. You didn't have a confession. You didn't have someone who witnessed the crime, and therefore there was a whole bunch of circumstantial facts that the prosecution, working with the investigators, had to pull together, and they did as best as they could. And always you have, when you have a circumstantial case, you still have to prove to the jury beyond a reasonable doubt, and that is an incredibly high standard, and appropriately so. But today that burden was met, and today we've obtained the conviction against the defendant.
And what about that investigation? I mean, the surveillance video, cab ride. I mean, your police, your law enforcement did an incredible job piecing this mystery together in essence.
Well, I think at the end of the day, there was just so much of the circumstantial evidence. And at the end of the day, the defendant didn't take the stand to explain any of that. And I think the jury concluded correctly in terms of what actually happened. So, we're pleased with the verdict, and we're grateful that justice has been done today.
What was the question that the jury had?
I think there was a question about splitting. I think it was just technical questions.
Related to the verdict, though, combination, essence, guilty, not guilty on one or the other.
Okay, Marcy.
Did you want to call Marcy? John, can we get Marcy one
second? Yeah,
Marcy,
please do. Yep.
Jay, thanks. I believe Kira would be. Kira would be very happy that he was found guilty. And without the job that Mr. Dusterhoff, Mr. Anderson, and boy, Jen, tell you some nights. Probably we had the same dream. You know, it was just a very long process, but I 100% faith in the legal system. So, and I believe they did an excellent job, and I believe Carol would be happy. And unfortunately, she's not here, but at least he's not walking around. You know, he was found accountable, so.
Can you just, 7 months, the anguish, are there any words you can put into what your family's been through?
There have been so many different stages that it would be hard to, you know, really, I can't sum it into one.
Marcia, this verdict also means you guys can give Kira a proper burial, is that correct?
Finally.
What would that be like, and what do you have planned for that?
Well, obviously that had to be put on hold. Because of not having her remains. So now that we have the verdict, we will be able to, we've made tentative plans. So now that we actually have the verdict, we can proceed with those. And it will just